We have a study that we're currently doing now, developing a single item inquiry that we call the patient dignity question. What do I need to know about you as a person to take the best care of you, provide you the best care that I can? Again, it's a way of trying to put in a relatively quick way personhood on the radar. The plan is that this study, when completed, will have enrolled 100 patients and or family members. And the protocol really asks the patient to respond to this question. It's a brief 5 to 7 minute conversation. We summarize it in a few paragraphs. We come back to the patient's bedside. We read it. We make sure that we got it correct. And then the litmus test is, do you want this on your chart? Because if you want this on your chart, in essence, what you're saying is, this is the filter through which I want everyone to see me. And it's kind of like, if you're going to look at me, I get to choose which eyeglasses you wear. And the patient dignity question is a way of providing the patient that option of saying, well, here's how I need to be seen. So in the course of that study, there are nearly 100 such examples. One that comes to mind was a First Nations woman who was in her mid-60s. And again, this is just a few minute conversation, and I can't paraphrase it exactly. But what she was able to say is that as a result of having been a victim of the residential school system, she and her family moved 82 separate times. She moved for the purposes of not having to get too close to anyone. She went through life having big trust issues. I should back up to say that this woman was now in palliative care. She was dying of an advanced malignancy. She told me that trust is so much of an issue that people with white coats frighten her. She's worried that people are going to assume that she's not smart enough to know everything that she needs to know to make good decisions, and that she's not quite as bad as she used to be. Now, when I read her response to that question, you know, just these few short paragraphs, I was dumbstruck. I thought, would it be possible to look after this person and not know this information? You know, I think there's an instance where I suppose it's conceivable that you could go through the technicalities of care, you know, the instrumental physical aspects of delivering health care. But in some ways, it would be like walking in the dark. So there's an example where one simple intervention, the patient dignity question, I think made a difference between her being, you know, any other middle-aged woman with an advanced malignancy with the usual standard set of physical challenges that such patients encounter versus somebody with a very deep, important personal history that really shaped their long-standing psychological landscape and as a result of that landscape influenced the way they experienced the next person in a white coat who happened to walk in the room. The fact is, how can we know? You know, how can we know another person's lived experience? You know, how can we say that we know what it's like to walk in that person's shoes? We can't. But the way to try and get there is by acknowledging our own ignorance, by being humble, and by asking the question.